Here's simple reality, which is every disaster we've had in the state of Texas since I became Senate, I have worked and my team has worked vigorously to help the people of Texas.
He's worked vigorously to help the people of Texas. That's Ted Cruz talking about how much he's done for the people of Texas. Sure, I don't live in Texas, so I can't necessarily say that he's done nothing for the people of Texas. I just don't like how he's always talking about himself so much. So still, this is Ted Cruz talking about how great he is. So there was that one time a couple of years ago when that winter storm came through and Ted Cruz ran off to Cancun and has been ridiculed about it ever since. Was he doing everything for the people of Texas then too? Let's watch.
During that disaster, look, I got to tell you, I don't know how to string power lines. When we had a freeze, when the state was frozen, I don't have the ability to control the weather. I don't have the ability to string power lines. I was at home with my wife and my daughters. Our power was out like everyone else. And so I made a decision to take my kids to the beach. And to be clear, and by the way, lots of other Texans made the decision that they could go elsewhere to go elsewhere. To be clear, what I was doing in a house with no lights and no power was I was on the phone with other people in the federal government, talking in the federal government. I was doing my job, and you can do that from anywhere. There were multiple other Texas officials who were out of state who nobody cared about at all. But I get, if you've been told Cruz is the devil, then screaming Cancun is a wonderful partisan thing to do. But if at the end of the day, your greatest criticism of me is that I took my kids to the beach, I can live with that.
Because all I did was take his kids to the beach. So when someone screams Cancun, he gets pretty offended and says, well, what were you doing? I mean, it's not like you're an elected official or anything. He did point out some things he could be doing, but was he doing it from the beach? Did he point that out then? Because of course, Ted Cruz is trying to rewrite history with some angry responses to some random person so he could seem like a badass. That's one of his tactics. This is what happened when that went down. He got busted. Mr. Cruz wrote at the time, with school canceled for the week, our girls asked to take a trip with friends, wanted to be a good dad. I flew down with them last night and I'm flying back this afternoon. My staff and I are in constant communication with state and local leaders to get to the bottom of what happened in Texas. Did you ever get to the bottom of what happened in Texas? And when you got to the bottom of what happened in Texas, maybe with the grid or the way that the infrastructure wasn't actually supported the way it should be, did you do something about it? Did you get to the bottom of it and then shut the hell up about how you got to the bottom of it? Or maybe you didn't get to the bottom of it at all. Who knows? Because there's more. Because text from Heidi Cruz emerged showing that they had set this whole thing up. Ms. Cruz texted to friends and Houston neighbors on Wednesday, again, back when this whole thing went down, revealed a hastily planned trip. She says their house was freezing and she proposed a getaway until Sunday. Ms. Cruz invited others to join them at the Ritz-Carlton in Cancun, where they stayed many times before, noting that the room price this week was bare bottom, rock bottom prices of $309 a night. It's also good security because, you know, we're very important people. And also following his return back to his country that he represents people in, reporters asked Cruz again where he finally showed some remorse, finally about this whole thing. Again, he ran to a dangerous Mexico, by the way. Let's not forget that part. He ran south to Mexico, jumped over Trump's border wall and ran to Mexico, where those dangerous drug cartels could have murdered him at any moment. Sorry, more. After landing back in the U.S., Mr. Cruz offered a new statement with a different tone from earlier in the day, when he had tried to explain the vacation without regrets and left the impression that it might have been always a one-day trip for him. Speaking to reporters after his arrival home, he conceded that the trip was obviously a mistake and that he had begun having second thoughts as soon as he boarded the plane to Mexico, intent on a few days of remote work in the sun. That may have been the only sentence he said that was honest. He probably looked up and said, man, if anybody catches me doing this is going to be a problem. And it was. And he showed some remorse at the back end. How come right then he didn't say, I can't string up power lines, you losers? I'm going to sit in Cancun on the beach, hang out with my family and family friends, drink me a couple of Mai Tais, and you guys can just sit there and freeze over it. It's one of those things. You can't be the guy who always criticizes what AOC hasn't done in New York because she has no power to do something in the city of New York with some kind of thing that the mayor may actually do. They do it all the time. They'll say, oh, man, look at that. Lib California. So anybody who lives in California or is a representative of California is controlling what's happening from the top to the bottom of California. But when it comes to Ted Cruz, who literally left in the middle of a snowstorm when there were things that they could have done better in that state to prevent people losing their power and dying during that storm, he left. And maybe he was going to work from the beaches of Cancun. Didn't say that then. He was saying he might. and was hoping to get away with it. And when he didn't get away with it, he then had to apologize. So again, it's the same thing as changing the narrative just so you can continue to be that politician, Trae.
Yeah, I mean, it's very clear, like, he doesn't feel at all bad about the decision he made or whatever. He's just upset that he got caught, you know. Now he's reached the point where he's, like, just being defensive and outraged over it for, you know, no good reason. I don't know how you couldn't know that that's going to look, but he had to know it would look bad. He just had to also convince himself that, like, he could get away with it somehow. And I don't know how he thought that was going to work. Like, my sons are 10 and 11. I don't blame somebody that's got, like, you know, elementary, middle school age kids, whatever, during a situation like that, sending them and their wife elsewhere. If they have somewhere else they can send them, they have the capacity to do that when some stuff like that is going down. I don't blame anybody for that. But, like, if you're in a position like Ted Cruz is in, you have to know that, like, you can't also go. You know what I mean? Like, he had to know better than that. But Ted Cruz is not good at knowing better than stuff, you know? You know what I mean? Like, he's not known for his general good judgment. His continuing presence sort of amazes me, because it feels like, it's just always felt to me like nobody really likes Ted Cruz. Like even in Texas, it feels like they don't really like him. But I guess it's like there's just enough people in Texas that are like, but he's better than the alternative, which is a godless liberal, presumably, or whatever. So I guess that's enough to keep him around. I don't know. But it's weird because he seems universally reviled. It was like that. Al Franken had that famous quote about him or whatever. It's like, I like Ted Cruz more than most of my colleagues in Congress, and I hate Ted Cruz. So,
I think it was Lindsey Graham. The oft-booed Lindsey Graham also said something in one of those events. I'm going to look that up too. But Lindsey Graham, I think, said something along the lines of no one likes Ted Cruz in Congress or in the Senate. That's fellow Republican who, again, knows a thing or two about people not liking him, because he keeps getting booed everywhere he goes. Sure. Last thing, though, Colin Allred, who's running against him, then also did point out one thing and took advantage of this one particular moment, reposted that event and said, I don't know how to string up power lines either. But like so many other Texans who saw it was time to step up, I found my way to the food bank to help get resources to Texans. And I assume he was there, but there's always the food bank talk. Politicians always talk about going to serve food on Thanksgiving and Christmas. I mean, again, this isn't the criticism of folks like that, but as many things, as I point out, there was a lot of responsibilities that Ted Cruz could have pulled off, and he didn't at the time because he was still traveling. It was a one-day turnaround. Who knows? Maybe as he was on the phone on the beach, coordinating with, you know, the governor of the state, maybe some personnel from Washington or some kind of way to bring resources. Part of what his job could have been, he'd be like, hold on one second, I just got to order this platter, and then I can get right back to work. Who knows? Maybe he was on that route. But definitely people are coming for Ted Cruz, because it's all, at the end of the whole thing, it's all about politics. Let's jump to this next story. Oh, yeah. No, one more. Go.
Well, I was just going to say, I felt like when we were going through the breakdown of all that, and he was talking about how his days were shaping up and what he was going to be doing, it made me think about how it also sort of illuminates how, like, I don't know, how much time, I don't know, how not that stressful or whatever that job can apparently be at times. Like, you know what I'm saying? If you can do the job of a senator from a beach in Cancun, it's not as bad as man than make it out to be, is what I'm trying to say. Because that's part of his argument he's trying to make, is that he's like, look, I could have been doing what I was doing from anywhere. I was doing my job, working hard, but I could do that with a margarita in my hand on the beach, you know, in Cancun. It's like, well, then you're not working that hard then, you know, if that's true. And they're always like just dying to get out of DC and, you know, go to recess and all this stuff. And it's just, I just got a feeling it's not as labor intensive as many of them would like us to believe.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.